Hi guys, and welcome to Youth Church Online for May. This is the second one of these we've done. So if you didn't see April's and you like this one, you want more, check that out. What we've got coming up today, so we've got a few good news stories a little bit later with Grace, just to give a break from all the doom and gloom. We've got singing that we normally do in Tin Can, and this month I've got a couple of my friends, Ian and Grace, from Liverpool to record that, so that's really good. That's coming up. I'm going to be talking a little bit later about fear, something that I found just thinking about all the time. Every time you switch on the TV, it's fear. People are afraid to do all sorts of things, so stay tuned for that. But right now, we're going to do a little bit of an advert for something that we've been thinking of as a Tin Can team to stay in touch with you all. So check that out.
You'll ever do. Two can be as bad as one. It's the loneliest number since the number one. No is the saddest experience you'll ever know. Yes, it's the saddest experience you'll ever know. Because one is the loneliest number that you'll ever do. One is the loneliest number that you'll ever know. It's just no good anymore since you spend my time just making rhymes of yesterday. Because one is the loneliest number that you'll ever do. One is the loneliest number that you'll ever know. One is the loneliest number. One is the loneliest number. One is the loneliest number that you'll ever do. One is the loneliest number, much, much worse than two. One is a number divided by two.
As you can see, Tin Can's not much fun on my own. So one of the things me and the rest of the leaders have thought we could do is try and meet over something called Zoom. And that's basically a video chat app that you can have on your phone or on your computer. The point of this is going to be just to catch up, to check you're all doing okay. And so you can catch up with each other. They're going to play some games like we do normally at Tin Can, whether it's Empires or I've got loads of ideas of different games we can play. And then from time to time as well, me or one of the other leaders will just share a little thoughts to kind of encourage you just in lockdown. What I need you to do then, because we need parents' permission for this, is to send us a message on Instagram or get your parents to email us on our email address, which is on screen. Basically what we're going to then do is send them an email with a letter we've written which outlines what Zoom's all about, what we're going to be doing in these sessions, but also a few safeguards and concerns they might have as well. And then what they're going to have to do then is to reply to that email saying they give consent for you to come on with us, and also share a contact number for them as well. Alright, so I hope you can join us, and we'll get this set up as soon as we've had a few parental permission forms back. So yeah, watch this space. Okay, as you can see, Tin Can's pretty naff all here on my own. So do hope you get involved with the Zoom sessions. If any of that wasn't clear from the video, just send us a message on Instagram and we'll clarify how to get involved. And we're going to go and do some singing now with my friends from Liverpool, Mills and Grace. But what that is, and the reason we do that at church, is it's just a different way to connect with God. So think of it as the same way as praying and singing. If you don't want to join in, then that's fine. You either skip through or just have a listen, because they've both got really good voices. If you like any of these songs as well, you want to listen to them in the week, they're on our Spotify playlist. We put that up every Monday, but you can find it in our highlights section on the Instagram page as well. Alright, enjoy.
Lord, just pray that we can just enjoy some worship together, that we can enjoy your word, and that at home with our families or whoever we're with, Lord Jesus, that you're with us. And we know and we find comfort in that, Lord, and that we can always have trust and have faith in you, and that whatever the outcome of all of this or whatever happens next, Lord Jesus, we just continue to look to you and take this time also to worship, Lord, and then about your word, that we can just grow more in your truth, Lord, and become more and more confident in you.
Place that you would bear my cross.
Great, thanks guys. As I said before, if you enjoyed any of them songs, you can find them on our Spotify playlist. There'll be a new song highlighted tomorrow on our stories, so check that out. We're now going to go over to Grace for some good news stories, a bit of a break from all the doom and gloom.
Hi everyone, and welcome to our good news section where we're going to celebrate some of the really fab stuff that's happened over the last 5 or 6 weeks. So number one is this amazing story in India. All these thousands and thousands of flamingos have flocked to this city, and because there's no one there, everyone's in lockdown, they've been able to flourish, they've got loads to eat, and all the water has turned pink. Amazing. Number two has to be Captain Tom. I know everyone's heard about what a trooper he is. He's raising millions for the NHS, but this picture shows his birthday cards that he got for his 100th birthday, and there's over 100,000 of them, which is epic. Number three is all the amazing stories of people that have overcome COVID and recovered. And here are two stories of two of the youngest people in the UK that have overcome it, 6 and 7 weeks old. Number four is actually a conspiracy theory. There was a WhatsApp recording leaked a couple of weeks ago about the UK government actually baking a giant lasagna for everyone in the UK to eat and share for COVID-19. Obviously it was a fake, but I still think that's a really cool idea. Finally, how much better does it get than stories about food? And there's one guy in a village in England who has promised to buy all the villagers, so it's about 200 people, fish and chips every Friday for the next 12 weeks. And that is some seriously good news. So I hope that helped cheer you up. I hope you guys are staying positive and keeping really well. See you soon. Bye.
When I was younger, I used to be terrified of the dark. So if I was in a dark room, I would close my eyes and try and run all the way to the light switch. Invariably, this would usually mean me falling over and crashing on the ground, afraid to open my eyes. And so my parents would usually find me on the floor screaming as they tried to sort of switch the light on so I would open my eyes and see where I was.
I'm really scared of bats. I do not like them at all. I think they're some sort of deranged creatures, which are a mix between a rat, a flying rat, bird. I don't like them at all. I regularly have nightmares about them.
I really fear reptiles, so snakes, lizards, anything like that. Oh, I just can't stand them. The thought of it really makes me cringe and makes me fearful.
My biggest irrational fear is slugs. Can't explain why. Always been absolutely terrified of them.
During lockdown, I've become scared of razors, and that's why I've got this beard. And as well as that, I'm really scared of heights. I hate them.
I hate rats. I hate mice. I hate vermin like that. When I see them, I think, oh! If one was in the room, I would have to go out. Absolutely fearful of them, and I really don't like them.
Ever since I was a kid, I've hated flying in aeroplanes. I don't know why. That fear was kind of cured a little bit when I went to Ukraine because I had to fly about 8 times, but yeah, I don't like airplanes very much.
As you can guess from that video, we're going to quickly look at the topic of fear. This is something that affects us all, isn't it? And we're all afraid of different things, whether they're silly ones, like Sarah being afraid of slugs, or whether they're more serious ones. My biggest fear is sharks, believe it or not. And I think it comes from when I was around 7 or 8, I used to have this friend who loved watching shark movies. His absolute favourite was a movie called Deep Blue Sea. And I think, to be honest, it's that movie that made me so scared of sharks because I used to watch it all the time. I'm going to play a clip of it now so you can see how pathetic the CGI was when I was 7 or 8. But tell me you wouldn't be terrified of this of sharks after watching this as a 7 or 8 year old.
Nature can be lethal, but it doesn't hold a candle to man. Now you've seen how bad things can get and how quick they can get that way. Well, they can get a whole lot worse. So we're not going to fight anymore. We're going to pull together and we're going to find a way to get out of here. First, we're going to seal off this...
Did you jump? Every time I watch it, I jump out of my skin, even though I've seen it tons of times. I showed Sarah today and was like, do you reckon this is too scary for Tin Can? And she just started laughing at me, being like, that's the most ridiculous CGI shark I've ever seen. So let me know if you jumped and I'm not alone. But the reason I wanted to talk about fear is because I can see loads of it going around. You know, we are experiencing something completely different to anything that's happened before, aren't we? We're all locked in our homes, not allowed to see each other, or some people aren't even allowed to work. Most of us, if we're honest, are at least a little bit unsettled, if not really afraid. This has meant people panicking and acting really, really weirdly. You know, I'd never have guessed that the first thing people do in the state of global pandemic is to go to the supermarket and buy one of these bad boys. You know, this was like gold dust a few weeks ago, wasn't it? Because people got so freaked out that they thought, oh, I'm not going to be able to get toilet roll, I have to get it. Yeah, I don't know what that says about everyone that they're more worried about toilet roll than food, but I'm not going to go there. You know, I'm not saying, though, that these aren't scary times. We do need to be careful, don't we? We need to follow the rules. We need to make sure that us and our families all stay safe. But sometimes fear and being afraid can make us irrational, and we end up not being able to live our lives properly. You should see Sarah around Slugs. She literally can't move. And fear is such an important thing. In the Bible, it mentions it 365 times. Now, to me, that makes me think that this world we live in is so scary that we need at least once a day reminding not to be afraid. One of those verses is in a book called Isaiah in the Bible, chapter 41. Mandy, what does that say?
Don't worry, I'm with you. Don't be afraid because I'm your God. I will make you strong and help you. I will support you with my right hand that saves you.
Great, thanks, Mand. What that means is that even though we live in this scary world with all sorts of things to be afraid of and challenges to overcome, if we put our trust in God and put our life in His hands, He promises to be with us, to support us and to help us through life. You know, I've got this little fella here to help me explain that. He's got this habit now of waking up sometimes and he's absolutely screaming in his cot because he knows that we're not there. But then as soon as we come in and we pick him up and we cuddle him, he just calms down straight away. You know, most of the time he just falls fast asleep. The Bible talks about God as our Father. And it's a bit like that when Jackson's screaming. It's like when we're afraid and when we're scared and we call out to God and He'll come and He'll comfort us and soothe us straight away. I know this not only because it says it in the Bible, but also from my life it's happened loads of times.
So how does this affect me, I hear you ask? Well, I've just got a few ways. First of all, if you're a Christian and you believe in God, then you can know during these weird and scary times that you can come to God for comfort. That applies both now when we're in lockdown and the coronavirus is everywhere, but also applies more broadly in the future. Whenever you come up against something that makes you afraid, you can come to God for help. You know, whenever you are afraid, try praying, try asking God for His help, or just try listening to some worship music or reading your Bible. They all work. Now the second thing to think about is it can be quite scary to tell people that you're a Christian or to maybe admit to yourself that you believe it. Maybe you've been to youth church or camp or something else where people have been talking about God and really felt like what was being said was real. Maybe you think that you want to get to know more about this God who loves you so much and you want to get to know Him for yourself, but you're afraid. You might be afraid of your friends and what they'll say, or afraid of your family because they might treat you differently. I can tell you from experience that trying to be a Christian in today's society, it is really hard and it can be quite daunting, especially if you're a young person like yourselves. But I also know from experience that it's worth it. You know, you can know that the God of the universe has always got your back. You can know that no matter what people say about you, your future is secure in heaven. You can know that if people say or think different things about you, it doesn't matter, because nothing can change the way God feels about you, not even your mistakes. That makes the hard times worth it. Finally, maybe some of you guys are watching this and you think, you know, that's all well and good, Josh, but I'm not a Christian. I don't think that way. Well, actually, I think you've got a choice to make now. Are you going to choose to trust yourself when fear comes up? Are you going to choose to keep living in fear? Or are you going to trust God? We're going to sing again in a minute. But before we do, I'm going to pray. Now, you mightn't have prayed before, or you might be thinking about God for the first time today. Either way, it would be great if you could say this prayer along with me and choose to trust God rather than living in fear. Father God, I thank you for how much you love me. I thank you that whenever I'm scared or worried, you are there for me. I pray that during these scary times, I will not be afraid, but I will always trust in you. Thank you.
Okay everyone, that's all we've got time for this week. Just a quick reminder of what's going to happen in the week ahead. So tomorrow we've got Music Monday, so there'll be a new song put on our Spotify playlist. On Tuesday, as always, we've got the quiz. We've had the same couple of people winning it the last few times, so we want a new winner. Alright. And then the winners will be announced on Wednesday. I've been working on a podcast with my friend Rob. You might know him from either camp or from Youth Church. And we interview this crazy Irishman who's living in Florida. So hopefully that'll be up either Thursday or Friday as well. And then on Sunday, we'll have a quick thought from one of our team. Ooh, am I boring you? Hey, yeah? what else, Jackson? Oh, lastly, the Zoom meetings. Don't forget to get in touch with your parents' email or get your parents to email us so you can join in on them. They are going to be a good laugh and hopefully they'll help us always keep in touch. Right, you're getting naggy. You want them to show me matching haircut? Getting this bad boy? I'm expecting some abuse, so that's how I'll know you stayed to the end. See you all next month.